Hey guys, YouTube's been real awesome about the community guidelines, so if you are over the age of 18, you're cool. But if you're not, please don't watch this. Okay, well, the last update on this sour orange diesel kush left off in week 5 of flower. It was right after I gave the plant its last top dress feed. If you missed the video and you want to see how I started this plant from seed and grew it up until this point, I'll leave a link in the description at the top. I started this grow because Spider Farmer sent me their 200 watt SF2000 LED to try out. I was pretty excited to hear that a budget LED had Samsung diodes. Finally, the experience of a premium diode on a budget LED. The LED chips being used on this light are the Samsung LM301B diodes, which allows the Spider Farmer to boast a heavy 2.1 micromoles per joule. And to ensure the deep and red spectra pars, the Spider Farmers are also equipped with deep red LED diodes and infrared chips. So it may not boast the greatest build, it still covers almost as wide as a spectrum of PAR as the premium LED predecessors. I have this 200 watt puppy set up in my bedroom. It's covering a 3x3 frame without a problem. I managed to fill out this frame a little better by also starting the Purple Punch and Blue Dream autoflowers. These two are in Gaia Green's living soil, and the Sour Orange Diesel Kush is in Coco with Gaia Green amendments. Since the final top dress feed was given to the Sour Orange Diesel Kush during week 5, I've just been watering when dry at a pH between 6 and 6.5. And as often as I can, I check the medium's pH using my Blue Labs pH soil tester. This plant has remained in range its entire life, between 6 and 6.5 usually, and sure enough, there's been no deficiencies. The problem with this small plant is it never faded off, right until the very end. I should have gave this plant its last feed sooner. The plants should be flushing themselves out slowly over the final 4 weeks of flower. Sometimes they need longer. So when it comes time to harvest, I should see the plant is depleted and yellowing and fading. Autoflowers come in all shapes and sizes, and they often throw you curveballs if you haven't done a little bit of research. A few hashtag checks could really help you understand if the auto you're thinking about getting is going to be big or small. Here's an an absolute beast of an auto flower, the Purple Punch Auto. This girl is in a 5-gallon pot, and it's about 5 times the size, or maybe 6 times the size, of the small sour orange Diesel Kush. I'm gonna have a seed to harvest guide on those plants in living soil. These plants will be a better demonstration of what a beefed up budget LED light like the Spider Farmer can do. The Patreons have already seen an update into how that run is going. And if you feel antsy and want to watch some extra videos and support the channel at the same time, you can join, even if it's just for 1 month. I just want to say thanks though, Patreons and subscribers both, for supporting the channel by watching, commenting, and liking. I think next time, when I end up with a plant with no fate deep into the flowering cycle like this one, I'll probably be more preemptive and actually flush the plant out, which is something you don't hear with Amendment Grows. But this girl, I amended a little late in the flower, and it has a high concentration of fertilizer in the medium. So flushing this plant would have done it some good. Despite the lack of fade, I'm not worried. My intentions are to press this entire plant into fresh rosin. This sour orange Diesel Kush is quite the concoction of a long lineage, but its main makeup comes from the original Diesel and sour orange. From there, they went on to further cross that a couple more times. I'm not entirely sure if the seed I grew was a good example of what seems like a big genetic project. From sprout, it's suggested it takes 75 days to finish out. And well, I cut my plant on day 82. And honestly, it was a weird auto. It wasn't the easiest autoflower to train down because of how it was growing structurally. It just seemed like genetically something was going on. The top buds dramatically seemed to progress more than some of the lower branches. It is normal for lower buds to not develop as quick as the top sites, but this was looking a little unusual. I didn't want to bother doing a staggered harvest on this small auto. With everything I have going on, it just seemed dumb. I don't think I'm willing to invest my time on this genetic again, especially with strains like this Purple Punch, which is something worthwhile of showing. I may be knocking this plant down a bit, but this fuely citrus orange terp profile it has is a huge plus to this otherwise kind of ridiculous plant. My last video was a drying and curing guide. I go over in detail how I would chop down a plant with this kind of bud structure. So if you want more information on how I harvested and dried the plant, just look for the link in the top of the description of this video. I'll also leave a link and coupon code to the Spider Farmer LED. For anyone looking for a really good budget light, this is a great option. Next week, I'm tackling the 8x2 closet, and I'll be showing the results of the BC Godbud and Strawberry Cough closet run. Subscribe if you're new, because there is a lot more big plants, big buds, and bigger grows to show you. Thanks for growing with me today, and I'll talk to you in the comments.